have you ever felt?
Are you listening? Damn. Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to Goldcrest Valley, Farming Simulator 17. Oh, Mr. Blue Farms. Don't I look beautiful sitting in this nice white old truck? I just look so handsome. Hey, wait, come back here. I wasn't done. Hey, guys. My peoples, what's up? Guy's aggravating the guy. I'm kind of mad. I'm mad, folks. Look here. Car comes by. Pow! Right inside my trailer. My truck. They're sitting out in the road. And I turn over here. And look. Daggum weight's almost out in the road. Come on now. It's a brand new tractor. Kind of just sitting here. Header up on it. Look like the tire's half flat. What's going on with these people? What? Oh, that's a sign. I thought there was somebody fixing to hit me. Sarah's gone. Boo's gone. Jason's gone. Where are all these folks at? Crops ready to be cut. Wait a second. What's going on over here? What's this here? What the? Oh. I spoke too soon, folks. They've been over here setting up stuff. Ain't that nice? They're getting ready to cut some trees. Got one down. What's it? I grab this? Oh, it's too heavy. Alright, folks. Jason, Boo, and Sarah. Jonathan and Betsy. Not Betsy the cow, but Betsy the tractor driver. The cow. Oh, we don't have one of them on this one. Anyway, we're going to call her Betsy. Liz, Betsy. Then we got Jonathan, Jason, Boo, and Sarah. And me, Mr. Blue. When we get done harvesting this time around, we're going to come up here and flow some wood chips up and over here and make a big old pile, okay? Yay, a pile of, oh yeah, I gotta keep it PG-13. A pile of crappy wood chips. Yeah, there we go. Alright, folks. Here's our little buddy here. This guy ain't doing too good on this side. A little bit, remember on Goldcrest Valley, he had little bitty tiny tire marks? Well, there's something messed up with the ground over here. See how he just dumped? He's acting better this time around, though. Last time I checked on him, he's going back and forth that way. So, maybe he's doing good. Speaking of, speaking of Betsy. Betsy! Susie! Hey, Susie. Where's Betsy at? Oh, she is? Oh, there she is. How you doing, Betsy? Folks, this is Betsy the cow. Okay? We got two Betsys on this farm. A two-legged and a four-legged. Oh, sorry. Oh my god, folks. We're gonna have to get busy. We need to get mowing some grass, putting it in here, and turning it into that. But right now, we got to get busy. Jason, go to work, Jason. 7 o'clock in the morning. Let's go to work. Actually, no, it's 10:44. I told him to start at 11, so that's why he's not here. They're going out to get lunch. I'm going to go ahead and start the combine for them anyway. Maybe I won't screw nothing up. All right. And we are cutting wheat today. Oh, wait, see? I don't even know what I'm doing. We're cutting beans. Shame on me. Ooh, they look greenish. Are they what, ripe already? Look like green dust coming out there for a second. Anyway, folks, while he is doing that, go to work, Jason. There you go. Always smoking me out with something. Folks, you know, I don't know about this game, but in 2015 Farming Simulator, your chainsaw would disappear every now and then, and you had to buy another one. I still got this chainsaw since the beginning of the farm, almost. Sucker still runs good. Uh-oh. Dang it, that one disappeared on me. And don't hit the conveyor belt. Alright, right on the money. Alright, in generality, wood chip's gonna come out. Can't see that conveyor. It probably already came out. But wood chip's gonna come out. Oh crap, they ain't gonna come out because I didn't do this. Unload here. They're gonna come out, hit this conveyor belt. Yep. Yep, you can see. Yeah, where'd my conveyor belt go? Alright, they're not going to unload here until I tell them to, so. Hop in this one. Unload here. And then we got a big fat pile of peeping wood chips. Yep, wood chips. That's going to come down from up there. And they're going to make a big pile, okay? All these trees here. Oh, dang. Hurry up, Jason. Come on, hurry up. We got work to do. This ain't getting us nowhere, folks. Not getting us nowhere. Let's look here. 176. 202. Ooh, I wish I had him. You know what? There's a little problem. 202. And then... That's it. Is it 25 foot for that? Freeflow HS8. Freeflow. That's the case. Let's do the next. Ah, Freeflow. 240,000 folks. About 7,000 away. We just might have a new combine to go along with Jason's. Well, it's my combine, but Jason's driving slow. He's driving it. Boy, he's got a lot to go. Fly on your head, something to sail. Here it is, here it is. Detach. Look at all the front of this thing. Ah, my weight. There's my weight. I've been looking for that weight. Oh my God, it was out of my nose the whole time. I feel so shameful. Y'all don't tell nobody now, okay? I feel kind of bad. There we go. Alright, folks, just to warn y'all up in advance, I'm not a farmer. No. Real life, I'm a YouTuber. Yep. Ah! Yep, I make YouTube videos for a living. Nah, just kidding. I'm a farmer. See, I know how to drive a tractor. It could be like my favorite show. While I'm farming, I could put it to YouTube and teach the world how to drive a tractor. Nah, I couldn't do that. That's my favorite show. I couldn't do that. Yep. Y'all ever need to learn how to drive a tractor or anything on a farm, go to How Farm Works, folks. You'll learn everything. Yep. Yes, sirree. I want more wood chips. More wood chips, please. Folks, this might be a very short video this time around. Mr. Blue stayed up all night. Yep. He couldn't sleep none, so stayed up all night. Hey, one of them went in. Yay! That's what I like to see. I like to see something working. Yay. Pepper E is blocked. I only got one person working right now. Jason! Really? How dare you? Don't you know reverse? Reverse, Jason. It starts with R. You know, you pull back on the lever. And I'm like, what? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. What am I gonna do with you, Jason? I can't do nothing with you. Love you too much, man. Yeah. Okay, there we go. Yeah, just in case y'all didn't know, Jason's my cousin. One of them. Got quite a few. I love all of them. I got a couple that's a farmer. I got a couple of them that drives trucks. I just got them all over the place. Some in retail. But you know what? Not a daggum one of them is a YouTuber. That's where I come in. Mr. Blue, the YouTuber. I know, folks. I ain't making no sense this time around. Ooh, that's a big tall one. Now I'm just thinking, folks, I'm trying to figure out which ifs or just take E straight to Lumberyard. I'll get more at the Lumberyard and we'll get that combine this episode. Yeah, episode. That's what I said. Dang. Okay. Made myself dizzy there.
Going in circles.
I just want to spice things up a little bit, you know, to give y'all something actually to come back looking for. I can run better with that salt running. Don't run with saws going, kids. Good way to cut off your toes, your fingers, and other parts. Do-do-do-do-do. I guess I better scan these. Nah, I can't do that. I was gonna say it's hard to skin a cat, but I would get my butt beat big time when my daughter sees this. So I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it. I ain't gonna run way down there. No, sirree. This charger. Alright, we're gonna wait on the stumps a little bit, folks. We gonna put some of these in that trailer. Ah! Sorry, Jason, I didn't mean it. I was slacking. Mr. Blue was slacking. Folks, this episode might be a little bit boring. I'm going to apologize in advance. Oh, dang, he got fooled. He got fooled. Hey, Jason, guess what? Guess what, Jason? Oh God, I can't back up for now. Can't back up for now. Y'all didn't see that, folks. I had to back up for now so Jason can start going again. Didn't want him stopping. Jason can't get no rest today. Ah! Boy, you better quit tricking me like that. Boy. Let me tell you something, boy. Folks, I got to watch Bugs Bunny again. I should say, you better go on out and get that. I got to get that plow moved out of the way. Oh, it's recent seat, better not be blocked. Yeah, this is what we need. Can I even get to that trailer? Yeah, I think I can. I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. Alright, folks, I just want to say I appreciate all y'all's support. I can't talk right, folks. I had too many Skittles. Taste the rainbow. Whee! Now I know this ain't going to fit over in there. I don't know why I'm doing this. Come on. There, oh, yeah. There we go. There we go. Yeah. Whoa. I'm getting that big boy next. Or that. Alright, folks. Reason why I'm doing this We're about $7,000 short. Yes, $7,000 short from getting our combine. I know, we don't need to go in debt. Oh, this is going to be on the wrong side. There you go. Need a heavy end on that end. I don't swing that way, swing the other way. How are y'all doing? What are you doing, Mr. Blee? What are you doing? Well, my peoples, I have to try to flip that over. There we go. Like that right there. But you put the big end on the little end. I know what I'm doing, folks. I know what I am doing. It's called Master the Saw. Well, don't ever stand under a tree, folks, while trying to cut it. It's very bad for your health. Here we go. Now, looky there. And grab and lay and voila. And y'all didn't think Mr. Blue knew what he's doing. I just gotta keep an eye on Mr. Jason over there. I don't want him getting mad at me for not empty him out. I like you skipped some down there. Boy, that better be skipping. I don't have fires, but nah, I'm just kidding. Hey, I got a joke for y'all. Yeah, I know Mr. Blue ain't good with jokes, but I got one anyway. Alright, y'all ready? Why did the farmer cross the road? Yep, that's right. Why did the farmer cross the road? Duh. To get to the other field. Oh, that cracked me up sometimes. All right. Y'all think that's $1 million yet? I think it's about $500,000. Gee, I wish I could find $1 million. What is the first thing you would buy if you had the money to buy it? Just say you found, a couple $1 million laying on the ground. First, would you turn in? Second, what would you do with it? Would you buy a house? Would you buy a car? Would you spend it all on a gun? Mr. Blue probably would spend it all on a gun. If he was one of those people that like to spend money. Oh wait, I am one of those people. Now, the first thing I would buy would be a dependable vehicle. Yeah, folks, Ghost Rider's getting kind of bad. It's spitting and sputtering every now and then. But it still gets me A to B and sometimes to C. But anyway, my dream. Okay, he's stupid. My dream truck would be a Chevy or whatever it is, GMC. Either a GMC or a Denali 2500 HD with maybe a 4 to 6 inch lift, some mudders on it, some tiger claws. Be like a charcoal gray in color, four door. The back seat would be special made. What I mean by that, like the back part of it would fold down. And the top part of the back, when it lays down, would unlock, and it would be a gun case. A couple pistols, maybe a rifle or something. A couple grenades. Huh? What? Really? Now, I would have a secret spot in there for guns. I think that would be neat. I have a winch on the front of it. And then after I got my I guess you can say my dream truck, I would pick my dream house and my dream location of putting the house. Oops. Uh-oh. He did it again, folks. Us and soybeans ain't making it too good, is it? We done got well bread, and we ain't got probably a little over 12, maybe, probably, whatever you got in them. Hey, you look like he's skipping down there, too. We're going to have to do something about that, folks. I don't know how to beat you. Oh, man, really? Come on, Jason. There we go. It's not Jason. It's that daggum hitter right there. Because on the other map, I had a combine. The corn hitters work good. Well, there we go. Come on. Oh, man, really? I guess trailer's full. Okay. There he is, empty. Okay. There's a house there on the outskirts of Burnett, Arkansas, where there's between Burnett and the interstate. Some of y'all might know it. There's a nice 5-bedroom, 5-bath house that I would love to have, but I wouldn't have it at that location. I think I would have a 5-bedroom, 5 baths. Each bedroom have their own bathroom. Well, one of them would be kind of different, because like if you have gas silver and stuff, I wouldn't want them to go through my bedroom and go to the bathroom, so one of the bathrooms would be different. But yeah, that house there in Burdett, it was a 5-bedroom. I rented for like $650. I'm like, what? But reason why I know about it, a friend of mine a long time ago had it rented, and I came over a couple times before he moved off. You're talking about a nice, beautiful house. I just didn't like the design of it. Everything was okay except for the front room and kitchen. It just made different. Weird. Let's see if I can push this log back up in here. Whoa! Getting a spot where I'll be messed up there. I'm just trying to level that log out so it wouldn't be drooping down on it one side. But anyway, I would take that house and I would put it up in the mountains somewhere. I really don't know where. No, I don't know if it'd be Tennessee or Arkansas or way up somewhere else, but I'd like to have a 10-acre spot of land, and right in the middle of it, that house, and on the outskirts of the 10 acres, I'd have like a, what do they call those things back in the old days? They put water around the castle, keep people out. A moat, something like that. I'd have one of them around the 10 acres. Like a big giant ditch that stayed full of water. I have catfish and stuff in it, goldfish, all kind of different things. And then, on the rest of it would be like, I don't know, all kind of different trees, pecan trees and stuff like that. I don't know, I got some weird dreams, don't I? It's why they call it daydreams. Few folks' dreams come true and others don't. You just never know, folks. One of these days your dreams might come true, and then again, it may never come true. It's just part of life. You know, just because your dream don't come true, don't mean nothing. You know, it's just, you want it bad enough, you just have to go for it, you know? Gotta get those two stumps. Yeah, I cut them. Oh, I cut the stumps as I go, folks, because... those two trees there, I'm not going to do right now. They are a pain. Alright, folks, we are losing money as fast as we all get out. Guess I need to quit running my mouth and get to work, huh? I'm trying to think which way I need to cut these. If you cut them the wrong way, you have to spend a lot of time turning them around. Now, folks, I'm going to try the best this episode to get that other combine. I don't know if I can, but I want to do that. We almost got a load of beans. Let's see here. Where are they? Ooh, folks. Oh, Lord, folks. Look at that price. Look at that price down there in the Vintage Grain Elevator. Ooh, I hope it goes up. I know it won't. The bakery's almost up pretty good. Alright, folks, you see the tire tracks? Remember how I go, they're so wide? Now look at them. Oh, look, it's not parallel no more. Yeah, you would, Jason. You would. How much beans you got? I need to dump you when you get turned back around. Alright, folks. I don't want to start Sarah right now. For a specific reason. But I do want to do it before I plant. I'm not going to start the planter until we are completely done with this field. And I do have my reasons for that. Wrong way. Alright, folks. We got two things. One, we can wait till we get done with this bean field. then buy the combine to sell the soybeans. That way we don't have to borrow the money from the bank. You see, borrow. Oh, there we go. And repay. We owe zero at the bank. Okay. So I really don't want to go in debt, so we're get the money from the beans. Just wait and sell all of them at one time. And then sell some of these trees while we're, you know, cutting the beans. Let's see, I'm going to cut one. I want to go ahead and cut a couple of these down. And yes, folks, this is Tuesday, December the 6th. And it's 3:17 in the morning. Yeah, I did it. Just for the record, so y'all know. I'm hoping to get this out by 12 or by 11 o'clock, what I usually do. Whoa. But, let's see. Let me go for that. I don't know if I can get it processed or not. I got to go somewhere this morning. I guess it won't be. I guess I can go ahead and tell y'all. I got to go to the doctor this morning. Me and my kids. My daughter don't really need to, but I like to take both of them at the same time. Because, you know, if you just have, how can I say this? If it's one person gets sick, and that person goes to the doctor, and then the others don't go, the other person's going to get sick from that one person, then they're going to have to go, and nobody else goes with them. The other person's going to get sick. By the time you know it, it's back around to the first person that started. Does that make any sense? I think I just confused myself. But, yeah. That noisy chainsaw. Yeah, we got, oh, I ain't cutting that right yet. Alright, we're gonna put these bad boys in the trailer. We might just go ahead and go sell these. Oh. I'm off. Because if I get quite a bit, if I get over 40, I know I can borrow the money from the bank and just go sell the beans and all the crops and put the money back in the bank and beat it up, you know? Bada bing, bada boom. Bada bing, bada boom, bada boom, bada boom. I have no idea, folks. Just go with the flow, okay? That's a Mr. Blue moment. Okay, he's still working. Poor Jason over there just constantly going back and forth. You know he's going to get bored. He probably wishing he was on top of the grain tank somewhere or something instead of driving the combine. Speaking on top of the grain tanks, I need to get Jason to paint my grain tanks here on my farm. They're getting kind of rusty over there. That's something I wish would. Oh my god. He's full. And he's turned the wrong way. By the power of Jason, please back out and put your auger out like you're supposed to in real life. Yeah, well, this worked too. This for the ones that don't know nothing about farming. This ain't supposed to work this way. Okay? It's supposed to be turned the other way. Going that way with his pipe out. And me be under him. And him filling me up.
What?
Filling me up? Oh man, hit the wrong button. I hit the right button, I was on the wrong thing. There. Magically tart my tart. Ain't that nice? Oh, I'm gonna get out of his way. Aw. Go ahead, Jason. Go, 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 go. I wish you could do 100 mile an hour so we'd be done by now. Yeah, folks, we're probably going to catch him this time around. Well, here in a minute, I guess. You're getting a pretty good sized pile. Of course, we ain't done no wood chips hardly. Whoa, I'm in the wrong one. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 4 stops? Okay. I want to make sure I get them all, folks, because there's one reason why I'm cutting the trees down here, and you know why I cut trees down. Either because they're in the way, or they're in the way. Oh, wait, that's one reason. Come on. Oh. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't you do it. Okay, he's right there. Zoom in a little bit. There we go. Getting a pretty good stack there, folks. But we're just going to have to fill it full. Yeah, when Sir Boo and Betsy gets back from lunch, they should have been back by now. We're going to start them on their duties. Yep. Dang, he turned around. I was going to catch him before he turned around and got those ends down there. Catch our ends up that way we can start Sarah, Boo, or Betsy before they come, or whenever they come back from lunch. I wonder where they went to. They could have brought me a burger back. I'm starting to get hungry. Oh, this woodwork. Making me hungry. Hungry, hungry hippo. Don't you know? It's the big show. Wait, I need to change that. I might get copyright on that. Nah, just kidding. I have had a couple of copyrights already, but luckily I could just remove the song. All been song copyrights. So, of course, you know I never went back to my video and check it out. That's on the West Bridge Hills song. When I used to get copyrights, I just tell them to remove the song, you know, it removes the copyright or something like that. And I've never went back and see what the video was like after that. I bet it's boring, especially some of those long fields I've done with the songs. Let's see. I'm going to cut this one down. It's probably a tall one. Yep, it's one of the tall ones. Hope I don't hit nothing down that way. Make it go this way. Say timber. Uh-oh. Timboo. Oh, timber. Oh, my God. I have a feeling I just hit something. I didn't like that sound. Da-da-da-da. I wish cutting limbs on a tree was this easy. I got a couple of trees I gotta get down around my house, around my, you know, real life. Oh, good, I didn't hit that. But I got a couple of trees I get down at, you know, in the real life. They starting to take over my solar panel, so let's see about right here. I wish they put that measuring tool on here. You get next to the stump and you hit a button and you go down and it tells you how many meters you are or whatever you got it set as. So yeah, that's pretty neat. Wish I had a Scorpion King here. That's even neater. Oh crap. There we go. Yeah, folks, you see why I like using this, I don't know if it's called manure fork on here or not, but on 15, it used to be called the manure fork. Almost got it right, folks. Look at there. A little short. Ain't nothing wrong with being a little short, you know? Sometimes dynamite comes in short packages. Oh, wait. What are we talking about here? That's what she said. It was short. Oh, what? Do y'all see that? Am I seeing that? Y'all see that, folks? It's alive. It's alive. Kind of scared to cut it. I'm scared to cut it. It might bleed. Folks, I don't know where this time has gone. You know, it's already been 45 minutes already. Wow. Uh-oh. Ah, quick. I got you. Where you gonna go now? I got you in my power grip. Now, where's Jason at? Oh man, he done turn around again. Oh, let's see. Did he turn around? Okay, yeah, he's moving. Gotta go dump him. He's gotta go get dumped. Yep. Yep. Oh, no. I hope he don't... not that kind of dumping. Uh-uh. Better not. I don't want to smell nothing. Oh, folks, the things I come up with. Yeah, that's one thing I want to talk about tonight. Well, no, not really. I do want to talk about it, but I don't. Because I know it'll be a little bit before I can actually make it work. And it's back talking about having money and stuff, you know. You gotta have money to make money. If you don't have money, you can't make money. Does that make any sense? Whoa, what's going on there, Jason? So, there's a hill, that's what it is. But yeah, folks, you got to have money to make money in this world, it seems like. And having said that, I'm wanting to do something, but I don't have the money for it. I think if I make a few of them, I can make some money off of them. And what is that you say? What do I need to make money off of? Shirts, folks. Shirts. I've thought about doing some shirts with Mr. Blue Farms on it. I know I ain't big enough. I only got 22. Oh man, I missed it. Only got 22 subscribers. You know, nobody gonna buy no shirts with 22 subscribers. But I'm not really want to get them just to really make money off of them. Well, I ain't saying that right. You know, I want to make money off of them because, you know, you got to make a profit off something, be able to enjoy it sometimes. But I ain't like to go out and stab somebody in the arm, you know, hey, buy my shirt or I'm going to stab you. It's not like that. Yeah, I think I need to go to sleep. I ain't making no sense. I want to make some t-shirts and hoodies on the front of it, about 4 inches, maybe 5 or 6, ever how big the logos usually are on shirts, and put Mr. Blue Farms on it, and have like a picture of one of these little tractors or combines in the middle of that. I have like Mr. Blue across the top, and at the bottom, I have Farms. And then on the back of it, it'll be a bigger picture of the logo. Yeah. You know, I wouldn't mark them up very much. Say like I get the shirt for $8. Okay, it costs me $8 to get it. I would mark it up to like $10 a piece, you know, $2. I don't think it would be a bad deal. Even if I go $12 a shirt, that's still cheaper than a lot of places, because a lot of places around here, you know, you get a personalized shirt done, it's going to cost you $18, $20 around here most time, depending on what size it is. And good Lord, folks, you know, hate to tell my size, but, you know, I'm a big boy. I use a 4 and a 5X. A lot of places want to rob you around here, you know. Shouldn't be that way. A lot of folks want to take out something, $5, and, oh Lord. $5 and mark it up $20. You know, all that's their profit. I just don't see that. I know that's how folks make it in the world, but you really want to get your stuff out there and get your name out. You know, you want to go kind of cheap. You want somebody that's like, hey, that hoodie, only $20 for a hoodie? Well, I don't know how much my hoodie's going to go for, but, you know, just saying. Everybody else is charging almost $45, $50 for a hoodie when you got yours for $20, $25 made out of the same material, probably even better material because it's going to be, you know, good quality because you don't want people to think you're ripping them off. How did I get on this subject? But it's just saying, folks, I do want to start making shirts, so put me a comment down at the bottom. You would want one. You know, this won't happen anytime soon. It's just to get a theory. I might even try to put a little thing in there, one of those pole counter deals. That sounded wrong, but you know what I mean. That does the counting for you, like yes or no. See how many yes and no's I get. Something like that. Anyway, if you don't want to do that, just leave a comment. Come on, little bit piece of wood there. Let me get you in just a little bit further. Into the grinder you go. And you're not making me no wood chips as you go. Wow. He's always at the wrong end. Let's see here. Folks, we're getting lack of time. Lack of time. But yeah, you know, I really don't know. I've been thinking about that, you know. Find somebody around here that does a pretty good quote on shirts and hoodies. Maybe some other things, you know, Boggins or something. And I think if I can get a couple of my cousins to get some, hint, hint, and get my name out there a little bit more, maybe I'll get more subscribers and start making some money on the side, selling shirts and stuff. You know, it don't even have to have Mr. Blue on there. Maybe put any kind of logo you want on there. Who knows? Just a thought in the making. But serious folks, I thought about doing that after the first of the year. I was going to run that by my secretary, but I forgot to tell her about it. Yeah. Sometimes they have some good ideas, you know. Alright, folks, let's go check on. Whoa, see there, folks? Look how close he's getting. That'd be good this episode, anyway. We got about 4 minutes left. I figure it'll be enough time to go down through here. And then, yeah. Call it an episode. Because I ain't got too many hours, you know. I can get this processed and uploaded and be on time for y'all tomorrow, hopefully. Ooh, I timed that. That's perfect. Well, yeah, it might be pretty neat to have some shirts and some hoodies, Mr. Blue on them. There comes the lights. There's one guy I've done some ordering from last time, and I think I had to have a minimum of 12. I'm just going to get the prices and stuff together, I guess, and kind of run it by y'all, I guess. You know, y'all my peoples now. That's right, folks. Y'all's my peoples. That's why I want to come on air and say it. Let's see here. Let's do this way. But, you know, like I said, it's just a thought in the making. Been thinking about it a couple of days now. This ain't said nothing. I figured what's the best time to say it right now in front of everybody. You know, I love you guys. Y'all support me every which way possible. So, maybe I get some good support in the shirts and stuff. Yeah, that's a thought. But, you know, that money would be put towards not really personal stuff, but it would be put towards stuff to better my channel with, you know? It'd be kind of based on it. Because right now, to really get what I need to do this right, I need to get my website published. Right now, you know, I got a website. Got some pictures and stuff on it and stuff. But it's not in the search database. So you go search for it, you're not going to find it. Now if I give you the link for it, you should go right straight to it. Alright, we're going to have some more ends to do pretty soon, looks like. Why you still got your lights on, Jason? Oh man, I just shut them off. Okay, here we go. All right, folks. I'm not going to sell this right now. No, I can't sell this right now. Yeah. What I am going to do. We're right at the hour mark. I know. I'm sorry. I keep doing it to y'all. Alright, folks. I know y'all don't like it this way, but I need my weight down there, probably. So that's why I put it on the front and carry it with me all the time, because if I had to lift something and I ain't got my weight on the back of there, we'll be in trouble. Switch to that. What a horn. There we go. We're going to go sell these and see if we can get at least 9 to 10,000 out of them. Don't know if we can, don't know if we will, but yeah. I want that combine for y'all next episode, folks. I want it so bad for y'all. Who knows? Maybe, just maybe, we get a good price for these. Yeah, I'm thinking about doing something stupid. It's going to take a while. But, I want to see. Don't turn over. Don't turn over. I'm going to make my own road. But anyway, folks, it's getting time to get off of here. I'm going to go to the Yumber? What's a Yumber? I'm going to go to the lumber yard. I'm going to get to a certain spot, sell them, and then I'm going to get that combine for y'all. And what I'm going to do with Jason, I'm just going to tell him to go to his grain tank, gets full, since I'm not over there to unload them. Could tell him to unload itself, but I don't know how you take that, but anyway, folks. That's what I'm going to do. Just let Jason get full. I'll let him stop at that. We're going to go sell these. Or I'm going to go sell these, I should say. Because I'm fixing to say goodbye to y'all. I hate to do that. But I'm cut for some time here. Because I got to edit this video. And while I'm editing the video, I don't see no mistakes so far that I made. So it shouldn't take long. Let's put the beginning and stuff on it. But folks, this is what I want to show you before we go. To all y'all new ones, it's Plain Farming Simulator 17. And I'm pretty sure it should be the same way on PS4 and Xbox. That one right there with the pipe sticking out, this one here won't do nothing. But this one here with a pipe sticking out over it, it sucks these up into the pipe and puts it over that way. No, I'm just kidding, folks. No, oh crap. No, it don't do that, folks. Be a little crazy if it did. But, I had a little one here somewhere. I think I buried it. What you do? Come back here a little bit. That works better if you, see, I gotta get up here. It works better if you have a call. Oh, come on. There we go. Yay, it fell around. Trying to do this real quick. I know it's kind of hard, it's time consuming. If we had a call, it wouldn't be. Watch this. $151, folks. That would have probably been like $50, $45. But the deal is, you can't do it on the bigger one, so I don't know how I'm going to get that in there. But let's see here. I think I can do this in here. You got to get them to where you can lift them. You know, you can't lift them if they're too heavy, right? See, like this here. And then you just take and throw. Okay, $43. That's for a little piece. The longer you cut them, the more you get for them. So, oh crap. Okay. I'm messing this all up, ain't I? See if I can get it over. That ain't this bad. I ain't never been this bad. Might have to practice. Oh, man. $321, folks. They say you get more money for it on this side than the other side. I'll show you the other side. I don't know if you know. Yeah. But usually what I do, I might do this, I forgot. You take your log trailer and back up across here and you ram it over here. And it'll sell the whole trailer. But a lot of times you get hung up. Other spot is here. Okay. You can sell there. And then up at the sawmill. Lumberyard. That's named Lumberyard on this one. Up there between 4 and 5, folks. There's a selling point there, too, for logs. And then at the garden center, you can sell wood chips. And at the biomass heating plant down there, you can sell wood chips. So, two for two. But anyway, I'm going to get off here and say goodbye to y'all. I wish we could drive the train. It would be so nice to drive the train. But we're going to get off here. I'm going to sell this stuff, try to get some money. We need roughly about 10,000. I don't know if it gets it off of this or not, but I'm gonna try. Got a lot of cutting to do. But yeah, folks, I'll shut this off. Be sure and like my video on YouTube now. You can like it on Facebook, and I appreciate that. But if you don't mind, make sure you hit that like button down here, down below. Yes, down below that you're watching on YouTube. Hit that like button, please. And also, if you're new to my channel, the first time you're seeing me, make sure you hit that subscribe button, folks. I'd be very, very grateful that you do. And also, right beside the subscribe button, and also at the end of this video, it should have, but at the end of this video, be another subscribe place right in the middle. Be a picture of me on blue hoodie. Get it, Mr. Blue hoodie. Anyway, on down below, at the subscribe button, there's a bell beside of it. Click it. Just walk through the steps. It's different for each platform. Cell phones, it just, you click it and it automatically rings, but if you're on a computer, it asks you to do something else, and then you just click the box and say yes. But hit that way every time I put out a video, you'll be notified of it. Hopefully immediately. YouTube has been messing up on a lot of folks, so I don't want to talk about YouTube. So far, everything's been wonderful, so. As with some of the other YouTubers talking. But yeah, folks, hit that like button, subscribe, share me with your friends, and try to get them subscribed to me. I'm trying to grow my channel bigger. I'm at 22 subscribers right now. And I wish I could get up to 50 subscribers by the end of the year. That'd be so grateful. Maybe Santa Claus will bring me a sack full of subscribers. Anyway. I want to try to flip this trailer up for us. Think I can? I don't know. I get more for them if they're longer, but I don't think I can back my trailer up in there. Jason was here, he could. Oh, almost. Okay. Maybe Jonathan. Where's he at? That's what I need. I need Jonathan. Jason. Whoa. Alright, folks, I gotta get off here. I love y'all very much. Y'all have a blessed night, day, whatever it is to y'all. And I will see you in episode 15. Bye.